Welcome back, guys, to Trails Through Daybreak. Our last episode. With six Oct-Geneses in our possession and our master's boss dealt with, the finale for you upon your return began with the members of Arkride Solutions having to think about their futures, with Van unable to keep them all on without constant crises to fund their employment. This has led us to speak to them all individually. So having chatted with Ferry, Katla, Rosette, Judith, and Aaron, we now talk to the rest of our allies.
Right, let's go downstairs, I think. And this one person to speak to is either outside of things, or Agnès is now available to be spoken to in the future. I'm going to speak to Mr. Grumps first. Oh, hi, Van. We just wrapped up the breakfast menu for the day.
What she said. No more from the morning menu for you. Don't care if you didn't get enough to eat. You lost your chance.
I'm fine. I'm a grown-ass adult. I don't need to eat that much. I just dropped by to kill time until I leave for work. Also, I just wanted to say, I'm so glad you all made it back here safe and sound.
I second that. Sometimes you make for noisy neighbours, but lately it's hard to rest easy when things get too quiet. Especially now that I won't be seeing my Cray regular anymore.
Oh yeah, I guess you and that guy from Cray had some history, huh?
I'm sorry.
Yeah, since he helped with restaurant stock, we got to know him pretty well.
We'll be going to his memorial service, as you can imagine. It's only fair we send him off after everything he did for us.
Right. Makes sense. Well, I'm not going anywhere anytime soon, so things should still be lively around the office. But the source of the issue's gone now, so my assistants might split off soon.
I'll believe it when I see it.
It's a little hard to imagine they would. Oh, I was going to ask earlier, but what about that racer? Did he stop by again? He has. He actually stopped by yesterday, thanks for asking.
Hmm.
That's good. I guess you're right. I suppose. He enjoyed his meal, at least. What's the verdict? Anything between them or what?
What? You don't gotta glare at me like that.
Oh, are you talking about Maxime? He's funny in a lame way.
He's got his work cut out for him before anyone respects him as a father. Good luck, pal.
No, isn't that respecting him as a father nowadays? He's funny in a lame way. Best compliments. Amazing compliment, Yume. You're so good at this. What are you talking about, Maxim? He's funny in a lame way. Hee hee.
Harsh. Don't let him hear that, okay? Okay, he wouldn't want to hear that, but still.
About damn time you lot showed up. It's almost noon. Move your lazy asses.
Yeah, he's not in a good mood. Guess I'll just head out and keep myself busy.
Hot meat galatin's been added to the menu.
To be honest, I think my best bet in that situation, or in a fatherhood situation, would be to classify it funny in a lame way, to be fair. I'm relieved to see you're all back home safe. You're as energetic as ever, so you can't just leave her without someone to play with, no? You got it.
Can't go wrong with any of them.
Depends what you sell at this point in time. Oh, money. 70k.
See you again.
Maybe in two more arcs we might have Nudie Max.
And Trails in the Buff, coming soon.
Who's the last person I speak to then? Oh, you've got a room up here, next to the bathrooms.
I guess if you're incontinent, old man, you can always have a quick shower.
I didn't even think that you'd have a room.
Oh, well, you've moved in fast, blimmin' hell.
Got a jukebox and everything. Doesn't play any music.
What's all these on the wall?
Interesting.
I like how he's not even got like attack board, but he's just went bang, slams them into the wall.
Wow, look who's made himself right at home.
As you well know, I shouldn't even be alive right now. I've decided to make the most of this chance. To try things I couldn't even imagine in my previous life, and have found myself rather enjoying them. The magazines you used to read were quite inspirational, if I'm being honest.
Wait, so this is my fault? If his hordes of more respectable students ever found this out, they'd have my head. So Ashlad isn't the uncooperative jackass I was expecting.
Indeed. He may be a man of few words, but he is an honorable, just, and determined one, capable of seeing the greater picture. Rank-and-file armed monks trust him, so I would be confident in Iscariot's handling of matters if he were the only one they answer to. However...
We got his boss to worry about. Their captain, right? One or 30,000 members of the Papal Guard and Iscariot answer to.
Correct. They took up their post after my retirement, so I've never met them. I believe their identity is considered a top secret, even among the Congregation for Divine Worship, to whom the Papal Guard also answers. I suspect only a small number of people know who they are. Several hundred Iscariot monks, the cardinals of the Congregation for Divine Worship, the commander of the Gralsritter, and the Pope. Whoever they are without a doubt the congregation's wild card.
But what reason would someone like that have to get their right-hand man involved in this? The Genesis, but they're more of a Gralsritter kind of deal. Actually, why are you even telling me all of this stuff in the first place? I'm already like a magnet for info I don't want to know as it is.
It's far too late to be caring about such things, my young friend. Still, whether they are criminal or legal, your old friends or your assistants, I genuinely believe that the more people you know and interact with, the better. Who we meet shapes who we become. Be these relationships fortunate or foul, we are all the more human because of them. Surely the past 5 years have taught you this.
Well, I just... People's natures don't change easily, I guess. Having you in Arasio was a huge help, as huge a help as it is having you here now. So I count this relationship among the fortunate ones, at least. So keep sticking around so the younger generation can kick back a bit, yeah? I pay you as thanks, but I don't think you'd take the mirror. At least let me get you something even nicer than that jacket you've taken a liking to. Anyway, we've still got plenty of time left, so I'll go ahead and leave you be. Take it easy, Master.
There are things in life you cannot avert your eyes from, no matter how hard you try. Whether you can realize that fundamental truth is down to you, Van.
I have said my piece. All that's left is for you to look within yourself and make your decision. Now then, I'll need something to pass the time. Perhaps a bike magazine or two will help. A special feature? Heart-pounding courses with heart-stopping views? Color me intrigued.
Magazines, they're getting everyone into trouble now. And the last person to speak to is a watering the plants Agnès.
Okay, that should do it. Oh, Van, is it almost time to go?
It's getting there, but we still got some time. I can't believe how lifelike this guy is. Professor Hamilton's students are something else.
I was told there's more to him sleeping in the sun than just imitating dogs, too. He can turn the sun's rays into orbital energy.
Makes sense. I remember that being one of the areas Professor Hamilton was researching. Still, I know you've gotten real comfy around here over the past few months. But it's almost time to start planning the next school festival, ain't it? Isn't the student council going to get real busy soon?
Yes, you're absolutely right. I'm starting to feel the pressure, to tell you the truth. The end of April still feels like a long ways off now, but I know it'll be here before we know it. I was able to attend last year's festival just after enrolling, and there was just so much to see and do over those 3 days. It was hard to believe that the whole event was planned and executed by students alone, even if quite a lot of them did take part.
Yeah, there's a staple of spring in the capital at this point, especially with how many people check it out. And with your current president at the helm, I can see this upcoming one being a festival for the books.
The other student council members and I are a little worried about that. So you did attend Aramis, then? Just like Elaine and Mr. Kincaid.
Yeah. I dropped out not long after becoming a second year student, though. Elena and I were in the same year, while Rene was a third year. The second he had the chance, Rene took on being student council president, because of course he did. And because we'd known him for so long, we started helping out with student council work too. Then Elaine stepped up and took the role of vice president once the former one decided to go abroad for a while. So there you go. That's how the festival came to be under one man's merciless watch.
I see. Of course, after getting to know you so well, I can imagine that whatever you organized for it was anything but typical. I'm sure Elaine was less than impressed with it. While Mr. Kincaid thought it would be funny and thoroughly approved, even though he probably shouldn't have.
It's like you were right there with us. I still remember my first drink at the after party back then too. Man, it was so good. You know how much of a sweet tooth I've got, but not even the bitterness of the alcohol could keep me from cracking a smile.
I should have known. You were pushing the boundaries of legality even as a teenager. So the festival came to a close, and the student council elections were held in May. That's when Elaine became the next president, and when you dropped out, I assume. You did it without warning, too. Without so much as a single discussion with anyone beforehand. So, how right am I?
You sure you're not psychic? It's like you're in my head.
Well, I know the average school year at RMS, so I just put two and two together after seeing the way you talk to them. That, and these last few months have also done wonders for my personal growth. I used to be this shy little girl who was afraid to leave her comfort zone. Someone who couldn't even speak her mind to the one family member she wished she could the most. But now, I feel like a whole new me. I can walk a little further, and I've learned to say what's in my heart. I have everyone here to thank for that. But most of all, I have you to thank for that.
I thought divining my high school years was enough of a surprise, but you weren't done, huh? At this rate, you're gonna have everyone running around at your beck and call even more than Rene. Or even more than Ren, sorry.
Oh, stop. I doubt that'll be the case. Though there is one person I wish would pay a bit more attention to me.
What's up?
Nothing. I was just thinking that I still have a long road ahead of me.
So you got to talk to him a bit on the phone after what happened in Arasium, but that's it. Yes, though I'm used to that by now. It seems like this year's Revolution Festival is going to be a big one too, what with the memorial service and more besides. It's no wonder he doesn't have much time to dedicate to me right now. But he did say we could get together after the ceremony is over, thankfully. Really, I guess that's better than nothing, at least you can still see him. That is true. Compared to Elaine, I'm very fortunate. I can't even imagine what she must be going through. She's amazing to have been able to do what she did, to make what must have been an excruciating decision, even if it was the right one. I don't think there are many people who could have followed through on that, Bracer or otherwise. I hate that the hard times clearly aren't over for her. But if you could just be there for her, I think she would like that very much. I don't mean to put that responsibility squarely on your shoulders, of course. Mr. Kincaid and the Guild should be there for her too, but still. I mean, yeah, I wasn't going to give her the cold shoulder or anything. It won't make up for what I did 7 years ago, but I'd like to think I can be there for her in some way others can't. Sounds like she won't be back here for a while, though. She's got a ton left to do in Arasion. What's that look for? Not proactive enough, you think? Oh, don't mind me. I'm sure just knowing you want to comfort her would mean a lot in itself. Really? Oh, okay. Yeesh. Can't always please a teenager once they get to that age, I guess. Still. What is it? Why are you laughing? You lovebirds want to get a room? I didn't know you were all here. Is it already time to leave, then?
You might want to get your eyes checked if you thought you were seeing hard eyes. Oh, I don't know. Did you hear anything special, Zeros? No, not you too, Katara. We were just making small talk, honest. I feel a little better now, to be honest. Our futures may still be uncertain, but for now we can continue to take each day as it comes. That we can. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said what I did earlier. Man, our boss is such a little troublemaker. Don't sweat it. They say not being able to read the room comes with old age. You know, one day you're going to realize I'm still in my prime. It's always the same with you two. Forget it. Let's just see what's on the docket for today. Revolution Festival's 3 days out, and I wouldn't be surprised if the aftermath of our matter's destruction led to problems too. It's only 10:30, and there's a lot of us, so I think we can cover all the districts in this part of town by today, right? Right. Then let's get to work. Agnès, Feli, and Aaron have joined the party. Select 2 additional members, so we've got, like, the original 3 plus 2. I feel mean sticking people out, but I'll take Katara and Bergard. I took Katara and Dudif. Yes, I totally took Bergard. Don't even know what I'm saying anymore. And so the sweep actually begins now. I see, like, one of those cutscenes with Agnès, the starting bit of the dialogue, they were experimenting with lip-syncing, weren't they? But obviously it was lip-syncing for the Japanese and not for abroad, so we had long periods of time where nothing was being said whatsoever. But it did look like that was their attempt. Right, there's a lot of red things on the board. There's a green quest too. We can now go to the Orba District for the first time. 7-hour dialogue stream time. Well, that's what happens when we start a chapter. It's always going to be a bit of a start off. But Jin's not here. I'm away from the booth. Please come back later. Don't try anything funny. I will catch you. That's weird. She's not here. Oh, I guess it is that time of the week. She might be hanging around the church. I just wanted my paper. Oh, it's just terrible. Terrible news. The Revolution Festival has been delayed. Are you serious? Because a ghost from 130 years past has risen from the grave and rent the Van Tail District asunder. No way. It's taken the president hostage. The government has sent Judith to negotiate. What? First I've heard of it. This is, well, yeah. Not these bogus stories again. Ever thought about writing a book, Grandma? You're good at fiction. Oh, did my story not land? I thought I would get more of a rise out of you than that. Yeah, you learn to pick up on it. I know that stuff is fun for you, but don't go overboard, okay? I thought it was the armor then, the artifacts. Oh, I just have to think of something more impactful next time. Something more upfront shocking. I better polish my skills before the festival, lest I sully the big mum's good name. The big mum? Good for you, Granny. I'll still wear clear of that.
Hey, big mum.
Right, I think we should start with our paper before we run around town.
Why, hello.
Eddie came back home the other day, but he told me he's just crashing here. Turned his nose up to helping out around the house. What's the boy thinking? He's just roaming the streets without a thought in that head of his. Well, I've tried all I can. I guess I have to just let him be. Maybe you do. Anyhow, if there's anything you need, I can ring you up here. With the festival coming up, it's a good idea to buy your gifts and other stuff early. You never know when the rush will hit.
Looking is always free, you know.
I've already got all of this. Wait, you're not selling me the paper? Where am I going to get the paper to read today, then?
Come back for more anytime.
No one's selling me the paper. Keeping your bike in shape. Nice.
Indeed. I had some free time on my hands, so I thought I might tune her up a little. I've been meaning to test her out. Let me know the next time you need to go out, and I'll give you a ride.
Lucky son of a... You better let me at her again sometime, capiche?
Eh, you would be more than welcome now that you have a license.
You know, Bergard's kinda... He has this way of keeping Aaron in check. Aaron hasn't insulted him once. It's very annoying.
That takes care of the cleaning. I suppose I have the time for a quick ride. I do want to see your work done. If you need my help, you need only ask.
I want to check your ride. You're a bit in the way of it, though. I can't. By the look of it, I can only check my your ride if you're away. Or with us is more to the point. Well, I may as well check inside here to find Rosette's at work. The office is bound to face heavy traffic on the day of the festival. As such, I plan to organize our submission documents and perform other clerical work in advance. Feel free to entrust me with this work and devote your attention elsewhere. Yes, I will. I don't even need food anymore. I will buy it, but still. Hawk has been busy lately. Can't even get away on his lunch anymore. They're saying all that mafia business has been put to bed, but the insurance company he works at is still buried in claims. I can only hope stuff settles down by the time the festival rolls around. Not kids are gonna lose it. Can we have Bergard in the party? I want to hear more dialogue from him. The issue with that is I have to like switch out Cutler, who's, you know, one of my two main muscles. Or Judith. And you like Judith too, right? Right? Oh, we got the virtual combat simulator to do as well. I forgot about that. We gotta grab Rosette and get her to turn on the simulator to get some training in.
Activating virtual combat simulator, beta version.
Divine Blaze Shizuna. Change party equipment. Well, I could come back here after buying some more equipment, maybe. If that's a possibility. I changed room even. I guess that makes sense. Ah! But poor switching out Judith. How will she be going around being all stealthy, making people not think that she's some kind of superstar? She had a chance to get Employee of the Month and failed. She needs to be punished. Well, I didn't know you felt that strongly about it. So this is where you snuck off to, huh? You blend right in already. I gotta say, this place nails both the food and the vibe. I think it's growing on me. Oh, by the way, I heard the Edith Girls Collection is the night of the festival. I've been scaling back my work ever since the festival, but the EGC is one stage I can't ditch. It's very near and dear to my heart. I plan to at least give the opening remarks. Oh, that reminds me, I need to pick out a dress. I'll still be around if you need me for anything, though. Just let me know. It'll give me some food for thought about my other job. Though the whole aftershock thing does have me kind of anxious. Well, she needs to go buy a dress by the look of it, so I guess it's good to let her go for now. 3 days until the festival. We've got one last big push. Taste testing the special menu, ordering enough ingredients, managing reservations. There's a lot of work to be done, so time to roll up my sleeves and put my back into it. Fio shall assist. Activating support program. Man, having Fio around is a huge help. Agreed, and we'll help whenever we have the chance too. Let's make this Revolution Festival the best it can be. Oh, thank you all so much. Expect some tasty treats as thanks. Place is really booming now, ain't it?
Can't go wrong with any of them. See you again.
Wine-basted burgers. Yeah, I don't think you can go wrong with that. That's the toilet. I have missed. The festival menu is always a big hit, but I can't get complacent. Gotta give it 100% every year, no exceptions. Make sure you guys get back early. Need some folks to taste test some new dishes I'm working on. Really? Yay! I can't wait! Your cooking is always so good! That got your attention real fast, huh, Small Fry? Now me, I'm interested in the adult munchies. Got anything that goes well with a cold one? You can find out when you do your job, you little brat! Quit slacking! He does like to chew Aaron out, but something tells me he'll have some snacks for him anyway. Gang's really settling in, aren't they? Aaron's already drinking the place dry. Can't rest on my laurels here. There's always pressure to come up with new stuff. Make sure you get home early today. I've got some work in progress dishes I want you to taste test. Listen up, no slacking off, got it?
Well, pick something already.
To be honest, if they need to like supplement income for doing like stuff in Edith, surely they could. Could they moonlight or temp with the Bracer Guild at all? After all, they recruit us anyway. Ah, more mud is the spot every single time. All my exhaustion from work just gets washed away. Thank you, Roman. Good talk. Someone up there we've already spoken to, by the way. Oh, it's probably Xeros, maybe. Where's Etoile? It's
Today's the day. My record's on the shelves now. My big debut's done and over with, but I'm still just as restless as I was before. Maybe I should hit up the record stores and see what people think. I do kind of want to see Raymond's jacket cover in action. Plans to put on a little show tonight to celebrate my debut. It'll be at the usual spot, the Blue Score. The owner there's really helped me out. I'll need to give this performance my all. It's the least I can do to repay his kindness. I know it's a bit off topic, but has anyone seen that list that's going around about, like, woke games and which ones to avoid? Guess which game I'm currently playing right now got a do not play for being too woke, because specifically... specifically, this love triangle is cited in it. It's hey, kind of like, it's really sad. I drew the jacket cover for Jess's new record. It's not exactly high art, but I heard it's getting good reviews. Here's hoping it gives his sales a little shot on the arm. All right, my actual job. Feel free to take some flowers with you, if you're so inclined. The best thing about it is just imagine feeling threatened by this. Imagine feeling... belittled by this. It's like, oh my god.
Say, why not take some flowers with you?
A lilac ribbon. Gift for Ren.
I hope I see you again.
What's next?
God, oh, we got three connections and only there might be four SPG, so we might have four connections too. We've got Yume, Ren, Nina, Fee, and Jack and Hal are in town. Looks like... let's send this lilac ribbon over.
You sure know how to make a girl happy.
Can I make any of these without attending the events? That means we're gonna have to leave someone hanging.
Kids are always so...
Oh, it's Natalia that's walking around. Wait, is Natalia's pathing being blocked by Xeros? Can Natalia no longer walk around because Xeros is here? And so Natalia was beaten. That's a 12. They friends now. What? They're friends now? You telling me the dog speaks cat? That's whack. And he got himself into the neighborhood kitty clique too. Just like piss off. Looks like Mr. Kitty's higher up on the food chain. Intriguing. As Zeros continues talking with these cats, it might develop an algorithm for translating their speech. That would be lovely. I look forward to Zeros' learning. There's a book about that already. Good talks. Wish I could find a darker spot. Too much light here. What? You got a problem? I ain't doing anything wrong, so piss off. I think the other thing cited that it's not a viable game to play is it's kind of like anti-nuclear weapon, anti-weaponry kind of stance.
Welcome. Thanks for stopping by.
So terrible. Alright, what do we got here? Burnout lights in the 10th District High Street. District 2 has a building with faulty HVAC. Go figure, I'd have to trudge all the way out there. I'll tackle that after lunch. This time of year is always a mess. All the holidays and celebrations bring in all the jobs. It'd sure be nice if Rebecca could help with festival prep out in the field, but... well, that's a no-go, for obvious reasons. She can at least talk to people once she feels comfortable around them. But when she meets someone for the first time, it's like she's seeing a ghost.
Do you know what you want?
I don't know. Is there anything in the bargain bin for me to actually buy? There's a variety of droplets now.
I hope to see you again. Do you know what you want?
Tough guy chronograph for Hermes.
I hope to see you again.
Yeah, it's not worth the effort looking through that list. I just thought it was funny, like, the reason cited. Now,
Ladder launched.
How fragile these people are.
Thanks, Arkride.
Hey, it's exactly enough to max out Hermes. Hermes' connection stage went up, allowing you to learn something new about them.
The white-clad transporter received white gloves. Well, that still doesn't solve my problem of everyone else. I can't exactly miss Fee, can I? Kana dropped by recently and we got to catch up for a little while. Now that things have finally settled down, she's continuing her studies over at Sylvie's place. I'm glad for her. She really is strong-willed. I'd love to go and visit her, but I can't. Not outside. I'm such a mess. Kana's such a strong girl. She handles the outside just fine. But then, look at me.
Lady. Need something fixed?
Any slots I can do? Well, first of all, I need to find someone without all the slots opened. Do you have them all now, Rosette? Aaron might have that one be able to open. Yep. Get that sorted out.
Come again, if you want.
I'm not even going to open everyone's slots up. What the hell? Everyone's at the church by the look of things. We'll go to that in a bit. We'll check out the far side first. When are the fixers coming? I'm just beside myself. I need to sort this out with Curtis as soon as I can. Fixers, eh? I'll look him over on the bulletin board or something. Oh, you are a 4SPG finally. The quest line of your family situation is now an R situation, is it? Just can't catch a break. My kingdom for another look at that vixen. I've only seen her in passing, but she steals my heart every time. Ooh, Judith. My guy, just quit while you're ahead. Anya was just over the moon this morning. Apparently they're doing some special class at Sunday school today. As a parent, I'm happy to see the school so engaged with its students. I appreciate how they tweak and refine the lesson plans as they go. Anya may be wise beyond her years, but she still has much to learn. I wanted to soak up everything she can while she's still young and curious.
I appreciate you always stopping by.
It's always good to see you. One bath will be 200 mirror, please. Of course we're having a bath.
I hate getting sweaty, but I could get used to this.
At least we got some more guys to even out now.
I'm really working up a sweat.
It's so nice and warm in here. In business, baby.
You look nice and refreshed.
It's the CP we probably needed more than anything else. Combat point. Sort of visited finale. No bigger reward than what I got for that. Boo. What are we doing here? One onyx weapon forged? Onyx? Onyx steel? All gifts given. We're still like 7 gifts off, supposedly. Did I miss some gifts? Papers collected. There's still 2 papers to get. 10 bonds mixed. All dishes sampled with 15 away. Probably missed one. 4 brochures still to get. Movie-wise.